What's up, Dino Bashers? This is KG4E, and welcome back to my ARK Survival Evolved Let's Play. This is episode 16, and I'm just chilling here with my gun on top of my Quetzal. And we've got a couple things we want to do today. Number one, I have been doing some building, so I'm going to give you a quick tour and show you what I've been doing. For those of you who watch my other plays, like 7 Days to Die, my other Let's Plays, like 7 Days to Die, you'll know that I've been having back issues. My back's doing a little better now. I'm going to start slowly getting the videos back going again, so there will be a lot more ARK upcoming. But I actually did... There's some rubber banding on the server, by the way. I actually did go ahead and do a few things while my back was hurting. I couldn't record, but I did get to do some grinding. So I'm going to give you a little tour and show you what I've been up to. Alright, so here's my new crafting room. I went ahead and put down an industrial grill. I went ahead and set up some stuff to make some cooked meat jerky. I'll show you how to make that later. I don't know if I had the poop collector down when I last recorded. I think I did. But I do have the egg and poop collector down. It is going ahead and collecting a lot of eggs and poop. Right there are the eggs I want, mostly. Those scorpion eggs. I went ahead and I did capture a few more scorpions, including a male and another two females. So, got a few scorpions out there. Got the poop going. I went ahead and set up a compost bin right next to the poop collector. And I put down a refrigerator. And for those of you who are wondering about refrigerators, yes, they're worth it. Refrigerators are freaking unbelievable. They're like 10 times like the... They lessen the spoilage by like 10 times or something like that. It's ridiculous. Refrigerators are really awesome. And this thing has been going through so little gas. It's not even funny. So that's been going really good. I went ahead and farmed up some more metal, although we're not going to be dealing with that today. Today what we're going to be doing is we are going to be going out to the north, up in the north by Volcano Island. I've been up there a couple times, and there is a place up there where T-Rexes spawn. I don't want to say regularly because I've only been up there a couple times, but every time I've gone up there, I've seen T-Rexes in the area. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to go up there. We're going to build a taming pen. Now, I did some Googling, and I found a nice taming pen by someone on YouTube named Nublitz. Nublitz.com is the name of their YouTube channel. And they came up with a pretty cool taming pen, and I think that's what we're going to be trying to build today. You can see right here, I've already made all the things I'm going to need. I got about 20 stone walls, 26 pillars, 31 ceilings, 42 wood frames, bunch of other stuff. And let's get going. Should be to the island in a little bit. And what we're going to do is we're going to go down there in the flat area. I guess we'll build close to the water. I don't see any reason to go any more inland. And I have hunted and killed T-Rexes here. Not often, but I have. So let's see what we got going on here. Oh, you see, there you go. What'd I tell you? All right, so let's see what it is. What level? Is that two T-Rexes? Oh, that's a Giga. Okay, well, let's not go over there then. All right, let's go back home. And what we'll do is I got another place I could build the taming pen. There's actually some T-Rexes that spawn somewhat close to our base across the water. It's not as like clean of an area as the Volcano Island over there, but you know what? It doesn't have any Gigas there, so let's go there. Anyway, check this out. I just came over here to the place that I wanted to set up the pen. And is it just me or is that a Giga? I have trouble telling T-Rexes from Gigas. But I'm pretty sure that's a Giga. Why is this guy acting so weird? There you go. Alright. You be safe, man. Be safe. I don't know why he's putting his head down like that. Must be some kind of bug. Whatever. So this guy's called Grim Reaper. Apparently, I think someone tamed a Giga on the server. Yeah, it is because they used metal walls. Alright, I just want to say hi to the Giga. Wait here and don't get into any shenanigans. Okay, wait here. I'll be right back. Grim Reaper. Oh my god, look at this guy. He's a freaking monster. Never seen a tamed Giga before. Oh my god, look at his hit points. Look at this. I'm not going to touch him because he's not mine, but man, that is impressive. I was going to make this thing out of stone, and I'm still going to make it out of stone, but I might upgrade it to metal at some point, because obviously there's Gigas over here, so. Alright. So first things first, we are going to grab some of those, and some of those, and some of those. Okay, this is coming along. Let me show you what I've got so far. This is the beginning. This is one of the gates. I will lure the T-Rex. He's got to come in a straight line. But I think I got enough runway up here. And then he comes in a straight line. Or from the other side. You'll see how I'm going to build it. He comes in here. You run through here. While he's in there, you know, jerking around, you come over here and you close the gate. Boom. All right. So we are going to be putting in window wall thingies. What are they called? Wall windows. Stone window frames. And that's so we can shoot in to trank them. Now, there's a couple things you can use here. You can use window frames. I've also seen people use these right here, stone railings, and they're a little cheaper. I chose to go window frames for my first build, but I might use stone railings next time, just to, you know, make it a little different. This has got to be at least 4 high. The first 3 levels have windows, the top one doesn't. I'm not sure why. That's how, remember, this is Nooblitz. Just check out Nooblitz on YouTube. Really, really cool build. I like it. And this was February of 2016, so I know this game gets updated a lot, but I'm hoping this build will still be relevant and still work. So the third one, it looks like, yeah, we'll just leave that like that for now. This is going to go this way. So this has got to be, I think, four spots. So 1, 2, 3. So we got to go at least one more. So let's go ahead and grab our trusty thatch roof. And put those on. I think they go, yeah, they go right. Yeah, they go there. Thatch roof. Thatch roof. Now this stuff doesn't line up with the pillars, but whatever. I'll put some more pillars in there. I don't know. I'll put extra pillars. I honestly don't care. There's no reason to put extra pillars in here. I'm just going to do it because I can, because I want to. I'll worry about making it look better once I've got it in at a spot where I like it and I think it's going to work. So why can't I move forward? There we go. All right. So now we just got to do this. That you can see the stone pillars through the ground here, but they're not like obvious, and I can live with that. All right, there we go. All right, so we put some more windows here, and then I'm gonna show you, we put the gate down. The gate is really easy to put down if you use the stone fence foundations, so they just line up just like that. Boom. I think we're getting some lag here. There we go. And another one there. And let's go grab the gate. It's 4. Yeah, I believe that's right. I hope I'm doing this right. I'll check off camera just to make sure I am. We don't need 2. I brought some extra behemoth gates just in... Not behemoth gates. I brought some extra gates just in case I needed to, you know, replace them if I messed up. All right, so number 7. And check it out. Now it just locks right into place. Beautiful. Beautiful. Get this jerk out of the way. And then what we'll do on this side is we will do the same thing with the ramps. If we can find any. Did I use all the ramps? I thought I grabbed more ramps. Not, I don't know, whatever. Just grab some more ramps. So now you just grab yourself some ramps. And this is the main part of the taming pen. 7... Wait until it's in its spot. And if those don't go down all the way, you just put another one. If you can. Which I can't. But anyway, they'll come up here. And what you do is you put when you want to catch the T-Rex, what you do is you put a pillar here, 2 spots high, put a pillar here, 2 spots high. And then when the T-Rex is running after you, run out this door and he'll get stuck on the pillars. Then you close that door, go around the back, close the other door. And he's stuck in there. Once he's stuck in there, it's game over. So, yeah. So then what we're going to do is we're going to come right here. And this is going to go like this. And this spot's going to go like this. And then the pen that I'm using here has a spot here for if you want to capture the gorilla guys. I forget what they're called, but you know, the gorillas. I'm in no way ever going to capture the gorillas, but I do like having this spot right here. So you can kind of run off, run out here, and run out a door. So that's going to work pretty well, I think. Okay, so this is the basic idea here. Got a little, this is going to be a doorway right here. You come in. I'm going to actually extend this out on both sides, 2 spots. with the with not foundations, but you know, I'm just gonna extend them out a little bit, give a little bit of running room as they, you know, follow me up. So what we'll do is we will put down some thatch. Like, oh, we can't put down thatch. Ooh, should I have done this before I put the door in? Okay, guys. The reason I couldn't put down the thatch foundation was because the door was open. But even after putting down the thatch foundation, I had to destroy the gate in order to get the rest of the foundations down. So that's why I made extra gates, though. Oh, god damn it. That's why I made a lot of extra stuff. I knew this would be an issue. Let's put these up here. Come on. Come on. There you go. Ugh. This one didn't go right. Man, these things are very, very finicky. Alright, let's get this right. Come on. What? Come on. See? I'm not even moving the mouse. I have my hand off the mouse. So. Alright. There we go. Okay, so let's put down the gates again. I'm gonna try and catch something small first. Now this isn't done by any means, but it's done enough. I want to start working with it. And this is all predicated on me being able to find a T-Rex in this area too, which I have seen them, but you know, there's no guarantees. So let's go ahead and put this down, and put this down, and put the gate in there. And the gate, and you can see right here, Nublitz dude had a nice little like side thing here that was nice. I liked it. I don't know if it really helps, but I like the look of it. So, all right. So what we're gonna do is we are going to put in some pillars, and you really want to use wood pillars for this. So let me see if I have any wood pillars that I can. Let me see if I have enough what I need for the wood pillars. All right. He put in 4 wood pillars, so that's. I will do the same. Now I don't know if these wood pillars are really needed, but, and this isn't done, by the way. There's gonna be some stuff here in the middle. This is a very, very not finished, but I kind of just want to play around with it and see what we can do with it, and, I think it's pretty cool. I think it's pretty cool. I really like it. Nublitz, you're freaking awesome. If I remember, I'm gonna leave a comment on his video letting him know I built this, because I really like it quite a bit. Alright, so that's open. That's good. Alright, let's just hit a trike for now. We'll see what happens here. All right, you. Come at me. Putting our Quetzal on passive. Trike should run right up in here. Beautiful. Close the door. Come right here. We got to put a ramp right there, by the way. Whoops. Ugh. Well, I got him. That's it. That's the idea. Except next time we'll be the T-Rex. Oh, he is not happy. You are not happy, are you? No, you're not. You are not happy. I think we're going to have to kill you. Sorry, you got to die. All right, let's kill this guy first of all. And then I'm going to put in some more ramps, and I'm going to go look for a T-Rex. You're not happy, are you? No, you're not a happy camper.
Not a happy girl.
All right, are you turned enough? Yeah, you're turned. Let's go. And done.
He's in.
Yep, I'm kind of stuck, but I'll get out of it eventually, I hope. Oh, there we go.
Ooh.
All right, there you go. And is she going to glitch through, or? Looks like she might, but. Nope. And there you go, guys. Now, you could probably make this thing bigger by possibly making it like, you know, using the bigger gates. But this is something that you could do in the game fairly early. You know, this did not take a lot of stone, believe it or not. I wonder if she's gonna glitch through there.
She looks like she will, but I think that's just her size.
You gotta count to like 4 or 5 after each hit. 3, 4, 5. 1 Mississippi. 2 Mississippi. 3 Mississippi. 4 Mississippi. 5. I think she's attacking the thatch 4. 3 Mississippi. 4, 3 Mississippi. 4 Mississippi. 5. 1 Mississippi. 2 Mississippi. 3 Mississippi. for Mississippi 5. I'm just going to record this whole thing and I'll just cut it up if it's this boring. She looks like she's attacking the walls, but she's not supposed to. Now, see, she's attacking the thatch below.
Yep.
Beautiful. She's actually doing me a favor. I would have taken that out anyway. Now, the reason you use as least amount of darts as possible is because you want to do less damage to them for a better tame. Also, there's a little trick you can do where you can force feed them food before you actually start the tame to get their hit points back, and then that'll give you a more effective tame.
Again in the eye.
Oh, that one got her.
Oh,
that got her. Mississippi, 4 Mississippi, 5. Right in the other eye. 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi,
stop
4 Mississippi, 5.
Stop with her little eyes.
1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, 4 Mississippi, 5. 2 Mississippi. Oh, there she goes. All right, so now what we need to do is we need to get food, regular food, and force feed her. Do not let her eat on her own. Force feed her until she gets her hit points all the way up, and then you starve her until she gets down a certain amount of food. And you'd have to look on the taming calculator. There's a taming calculator you could look up, and you could look it up on that if you like. It wouldn't be more than like 400 though. So what you do is you put this in here. Hopefully she won't eat it. And you remote use item. And you get her hit points back up. Hopefully this isn't starting the tame. The thing is, if she doesn't eat like automatically, then it doesn't count. It doesn't start the tame. You see her hit points right there. It keeps going up. Mm-hmm. Come on. And once you get your hit point, this isn't really a big deal on a level 50, but when you get a level 150 and you're trying for a perfect tame, you want their hit points to be on the high end. There you go. Now take it out. Let her starve.
And narcotics?
Yeah. You know what? Yeah. Throw some narcotics on her. I got some more in there. Did not start the tame. There you go. That's it, guys. Now, that whole thing with force feeding them to get their hit points up, I don't know if that works. I've been told it works, but I've not seen a lot of people talking about it. It seems to be a not widely accepted or known thing. Although I'm not heavily into this game like a lot of other people, so I wouldn't know it anyway. But that feeding to get the health all the way up, I was told that's what you want to do to get a perfect tame. Again, this is not going to be a perfect tame. It's irrelevant. I'm just kind of doing it to see how it works. Eventually, I'll be looking for a level 150 T-Rex. And by the way, I didn't know if this taming thing was needed, because I was like, well, I'll just tank a T-Rex. No, I would not have been able to tank this T-Rex. She would have killed me, because you saw how much it took. I mean, I got a lot of hit points, but I don't have that many hit points. So now what you do is you let her starve. Again, if there's a taming calculator I have, just Google taming calculator. You'll come up with it. And it'll tell you exactly how much food you need her to starve before you start feeding her. Starving does not up the taming effectiveness, and it does not make the tame any faster. What it does is it saves your resources in case the animal gets killed, basically. You also want to make sure she doesn't get hit. I think one other thing you could do here to make this even better is bring wooden spikes with you and make a wall, a circle of wooden spikes around this entire thing. Because if she gets hit, like if that was a level 150 T-Rex and she got hit, the perfect tame is out the window. You can't get it back. Well, actually you can. What you could do is don't feed her narcotics, let her wake up and then tame her again. But God, who the hell wants to do that?
There's nobody got time for that.
Yeah. So, but yeah, if she was attacking me like that, there's no way I would have taken that many hits. I would have been minced meat. And what you can do is while you're waiting for her to starve out, I looked up the taming effectiveness for a level 150, and feeding it kibble, you would want its hit points to get down, or you'd want its food to get down 400. So I guess I'll just let her food get down 400, and what I'll do is I'll feed her prime meat. So let's go kill some brontosauruses for some prime meat. Well, you know, we should probably wait, because the prime meat doesn't last that long, even on a dinosaur. Yeah, let's just wait. We'll let her starve about 400 or 500. We'll feed her and see if that works. All right, guys. If I am reading this ARK taming calculator online thingy properly, I only have to let her hunger get down 500. 10 prime meat should be the full tame, and I should get 24 levels off of the tame. Let's check. Let's see what happens here. All right, really excited about this. This taming calculator is pretty sweet. I hope it's right. Probably is. Alright, so... Alright. She's below 500. Alright, let's do this. She should eat one right after the other, and I should get 24 levels. It should be 99% at the end. And yeah, she's got to eat 10 times. It's going down 1% each time. So there you go. And so it's definitely going to be 99%. Should be 24 levels. Survive-arc.com taming calculator is, I like it. I like it a lot. Autumn Nicole. There we go. And I will name her Autumn Nicole after my wonderful wife. Come on, Autumn. Let's go. Let's go. Can you get out of there? You alright? Can you get out of there? Oh, you're a good girl. Yes, you are a good girl. Alright, so I did bring a... I brought a saddle for her. I'm hoping I could put her on top of the Quetzal and fly her home. This should be pretty fun. Oh, goodness. Alright, over here. The taming pen gets two thumbs up for me. The taming calculator website gets two thumbs up for me. This is great. The force feeding them until their full hit points gets two thumbs up. Just been really good all around. Really good all around. Alright, there we go. And nobody's going to color this one yellow. The last T-Rex I got, we got as part of a group. And they colored him yellow and made him look like an idiot. So, this is not going to happen with Autumn Nicole. Alright, come on. Get up there. Get up there. Yes. Stay. Okay. This is going to be something else. Alright, guys. Let's go home. This is freaking awesome. Yep, level 74. So, if I get a level 150, I think I can get a perfect tame. Now that I know about that force feed. That force feeding trick thing to get their hit points up, I don't know if it works, but people on my server have been swearing up and down on it, and I've never heard of it before until yesterday. You know? So, there you go. I have seen some people say it, if you go for perfect tame or something, I've seen some people talking about it in on Steam and everything, so I think it's a thing, but I don't know how many people really know about it, but I know about it, and I'm convinced it works, so... very happy about that. This is freaking hilarious. Alright, so there we go, guys. We got our T-Rex. I'm very, very happy on how that came out. And, I think we're gonna be doing some building episodes the next few episodes, because we need to get this, this area built up now. I think that's the next thing on our priority list here. Let's introduce Autumn to the rest of the crew. It's too late, baby. You missed it. Yes, it is. I had Autumn Nicole on the back of the Quetzal, and I was flying her home. She's on the video, though, so when this goes up, I think this is going up tomorrow. You can watch it. Hey, guys. I'm Autumn Nicole. I'm here to hang out. Oh, I'm sorry. I messed up. Hey, guys. This is Autumn Nicole. I'm here to hang out. I like Pokemon and Xenoblade and Nintendo. Right, baby?
Yes.
I got you, man.
Yeah.
Oh, look at how happy she is.
She's super happy. She's and you happy. Shot me in the eye three times.
No, she's good. Look. Eyes are perfect. The eyes are perfect.
She's blind.
No, she's not blind. The eyes are perfect.
She's blind like me.
No, I'm going to get her some... No, she is not going to wear glasses.
Yes,
God, damn
she
it.
Is.
No.
Oh, I'm going to get on the server right now.
I'm telling you right now, I don't want to see glasses on her. The last T-Rex I had a hand in taming, they turned yellow.
I won't turn her yellow, but...
No, nobody's going to turn yellow or put glasses on her.
Aw, baby.
I'll walk her off into a freaking... into a... I don't know. Something. Lava. I'll walk her off into lava.
No, you wouldn't.
No, I wouldn't. All right, guys. That is going to do it for episode 16. I'll see you next time for episode 17. Till then, take it easy.
Bye.